IV push medications. I get asked a lot to do a video on how to do IV push safely. So we're going to tackle that right after this. Welcome back. My name is Tammy and this is Nurse Minder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. So IV push medications requires several elements of nursing put into one task. Anytime we get a medication order, we need to be looking at our medication rights. And so we're not going to cover those today. We're really going to focus on the process that goes into IV push. After the medication rights are done, next we want to determine if it's in my scope of practice. To understand that, we need our parenteral manual. All right, so we're working with our patient today, and we receive an order for ondansetron IV push. The first place we want to look to see if we can give it IV push is the parenteral manual. Routes of administration, IV, direct IV is the same as IV push, and it says yes. But there's this number one beside it. That means I need to do a little bit more reading to find out if I can give it. So as I carry on in my parenteral manual, I see the required education, equipment, and monitoring. Number one says a healthcare professional must have a specialized clinical competency to administer direct IV. A specialized clinical competency means that you have received additional education in the form of maybe an online module or in-class training and have had some sort of assessment evaluation of it. That may include a written exam, a return demonstration with an educator on a mannequin, and or practical application with a real patient under the supervision of somebody else who can sign you off. And once you've been deemed competent, then you are allowed to do this independently. The next thing we want to find is the usual dosing. And here we are at the adult section. In this, so prevention of postoperative nausea, vomiting, we can give IM, direct IV, or infusion 4 milligrams as a single dose before induction of anesthesia or postoperatively. Treatment of post-op nausea and vomiting, direct IV, 4 milligrams as a single dose. And so this fits our order. 4 milligrams, IV push, now times one dose. What I want to go to next is the actual instructions for direct IV. For this medication, it says it can be administered undiluted at a 2 milligram per mil concentration over 2 to 5 minutes. Now, if I've never given ondansetron before, I need to know what it's like. Where am I going to find it? What does it look like? That information is also in here as well. Under product description, it's available as a 2 milligram per mil injection in a vial or ampoule. So I now know what I'm looking for. And it doesn't have to be in a fridge, it can be at room temperature. So it's probably just sitting on the counter somewhere. So I'm going to take a look for that. All right, so I have my ondansetron 2 milligram per mil, and I found that it's in an ampoule. Now this vial has got medication up here in the tip of the ampoule, and I don't want that. So I'm going to simply give it a quick tip. And you see the air has filled the ampoule and the medication is now all here. Gathering my supplies, because this is an ampoule and when I break off here, there's likely to be shards of glass that we can't see. I need a blunt end needle, a blunt fill needle. Yeah, I'm going to use a 3 mL syringe because I'm drawing up 2 mL. My order is for 4 milligrams. So I'm going to go ahead and get my needle ready. Now to open up the ampoule, sometimes we end up cutting ourselves. So if you work in a facility that has the plastic sheet that goes on here, awesome. If not, I tend to use an alcohol swab to cover around here. I'm going to push with my thumb away from me, such that it opens like that. Discard your sharps, and now I can grab my needle. Insert, and I can withdraw. In fact, I can turn this right upside down. You see the fluid is not coming out, and I can withdraw
my 2 mils. Okay, you want to label your vial before you go into the patient's room. I've got my ondansetron, 2 milligrams per mil, so there's no confusing. I like to put it on the hubcap so that when I remove it, I'm not losing sight of my mils here. So at the patient's bedside in this scenario, we do have normal saline infusing.
So with my saline infusion running, I'm simply going to clean off my port closest to my patient for at least 15 seconds. And I don't have to stop the saline here, I'm simply going to let that run. I'm now going to attach my ondansetron. And I like to turn it so that I can see all of these lines. I know I have to go at least 2 minutes and I can go up to 5. So my tendency, oops, a little bit of air in there. I get rid of that first. My tendency is to give a tenth. So like I'll take a push up to one line and I'll take 10 seconds for each subsequent line. Then the next 10 seconds, I'll push up to this line. Make this easier for you to see. 20 seconds, I'm going to push in a tenth of an ml. And then I'm going to wait till 30 seconds. I'm going to push in the next ml, or tenth of ml. Wait till 40 seconds. And push in the next. So you can see that it's going to take me, so we're already at 30 seconds here now, total duration, and I'm pushing in, there we go. And you just continue on this until the 2 minutes, or until the vial is empty actually, which will take you just over 2 minutes. Now, if my patient just has a saline lock, I'm going to clean this again for 15 seconds. And for the interest of this video, I'm going to fast forward this part. I have a saline flush here, of which I'm going to then flush to make sure my IV is patent. I only need 3 mils to do this part. So I'm going to push in positive pressure. It shouldn't be resisting. There's my 3 mLs. I'm gonna discard this one. And now that my line is flushed and patent, I can go ahead and give my medication. Again, I need to clean for 15 seconds. For the interest, we will fast forward that part. Attach my medication, get my watch ready, and I will do the same method. I'm gonna turn it so I can see. I'm going to push at 15 seconds up 1/10 of a mil and wait for the next. Push 1/10 of a mil and wait until it's 30 seconds. I'm going to push in the next 1/10 of a mil and pause. Then when we get to 40 seconds, I'm going to push in the next 10. So it actually feels like I'm doing something a little bit each step on the journey. But my patient's getting their medication in a safe manner. Okay, and we'll assume that this is all done now. Again, we need to clean the hub. Every time we access, we need to clean the hub. And because it's still full of medication, I need to then instill 3 cc's of flush, but going at the same rate. So I'm only going to just push in a little bit because that's full of medication currently. I don't want to go too fast. Just push and pause, push and pause. And once I feel I've got the medication through there, I can finish off my last couple cc's of saline flush. Push and pause one more, and I think that's going to cover it. And now I can just infuse the last of that 3 cc's. Disconnect. And you're done. So today we've looked at several elements that are involved in giving IV push medications, and we've talked about how to do it with an infusion and without an infusion. I hope this has been helpful. If you have any comments, questions, please make sure you comment below, like, hit the like button and subscribe so that you get the next video when it's released. Until next time, make it a great day.